Hello and welcome to FX Bootcamp. My name is Jarius Jenkins and this is your Asian session video briefing. What follows is the live wrap-up of the major item or items we covered during the session at fxbootcamp.com. Today in FX Bootcamp, we had an excellent opportunity to practice and put into use one of the techniques that we use so often in FX Bootcamp, which is finding ways to project where price action will occur or where price may have a turning point. We had a good use of this today as on most of the pairs that we looked at, the price action from the day before was not sufficient to use pivots or our normal FIB studies as a method of projecting where price might go. What we did was to use our projection using FIB studies, FIB retracements and extensions as a means of projecting price action. We had news, we had other things come out, but it was our FIB studies that allowed us to potentially make profits today. Let's take a quick look at how that was done. Let's start with gold, which was the first one that we did a FIB study on in order to project price action. We did this as we saw that price was starting to break to the downside. We had support from our indicators to show us that our trend, speed, and momentum were down. And in order to project a target, we were to use past price action to see what we thought future price action might be. We looked for the first point where we could find a move that gave us a retracement. The range from the day before was just too small for us to consider as a potential in this calculation. So we started from back here and worked our way backwards. This gave us a 50% retracement of this entire move. So we had this move from 82.17 down to 81.77. We had a 50% retracement on that. The 50% retracement would have us looking to the 1.618 area. So we'd be looking at about this area right here. As such, we marked 81.50 as our potential target zone and watch price action unfold. We saw that price came down total of about 20 or so pips to just about 62, which was one FIB extension away from our price projection, or within 10 pips of our price projection, and turned around and went back up. And it's funny how when it's gone back up, it's gone up to the top of our FIB range. Now, we did not make our price projection, but we did make 20 out of 30 pips, which was plenty of pips for a person to make profit off of, take profit on. Another price projection that we set that did not quite make it was pound. On pound, we looked at the pound, and again, the range from high to low was too small to consider as our starting point for our price action. So instead, we incorporated a couple of things. The first thing we did was to take a look at, again, from a low to swing high to give us a couple of prices to look to. Again, 50% retracement. Now, in this case, we had level at 1.9806, which seemed to make a lot more sense than 1.9795. One of the reasons why is that we had a pivot level and what we call a fibbit at this level. So we were looking to this level as our potential target. It was also a level, it was also very close to our psychological level, so this was a decent level to look at. We also went a bit further, as that was not our standard method of projecting price, and we looked at the overall major move that the pound has done in the recent past, and when we projected price like that, projected the Fib study like that, what we got was an overlapping Fib level. So 0603 was overlapping, gave us a great place to mark as our potential target. Now, you can see that's where we marked it during the class, and price came down to 17. We marked this at this point in time, at the beginning of the session, and within an hour or two, price came down to 17. It came down 6 pips. Now, when price came down 6 pips, we noticed that the euro and the Swissie, and the euro, the Swissie, and the yen were all making massive moves, while the pound was making almost no move at all. It moved about 6 pips in that whole time. Because of the lack of movement, we suggested that the pound was too strong compared to the dollar, whereas the other pairs were weak compared to the dollar, so the pound might not move at all, suggesting that the 6 or so pips that were put in from the time that the pound broke below its lows might have been all that we might have seen at that time. Now, the interesting thing to note is that if you were to play price action forward, as we can do now, seeing as how we're recording this after price action is completed for the day, we're back right at the point that we projected as the target for price, 1.9806. Now, we projected this about 18 hours before price actually made it to that point. Now, you would not have wanted to ride price up through all of this move to just come back down again, but it does show that even though this price, many people believe that these type of projections are arbitrary, they do seem to work in the real world. We've hit our Fib level exactly, 1.9806. The euro was another pair that we looked at. On the euro, we were unable to again use the pivot range, as price action was too small to give us any type of idea of what price was going to do. So again, we looked for a point we could look at as the swing low and swing high, even a little higher, the swing low and swing high, and looked at the retracement of that. And in this case, we had a 618 retracement. And this would be our target, 1.3424. How did things go with this price projection? Let's take a look and see. We had a break of our low, some opportunities to get in to a trade. We watched as the trade progressed. Price approached our first Fib level, our second Fib level, went through our Fib level and our price projection area, stopped at the bottom of our price projection area, and reversed. It's very dramatic how this is a very dramatic example of price reversing at our level that we projected based off of Fib study. Another dramatic example would be on the Swissie. When we took a look at the Swissie, we had a much wider price range, or relatively wider price range, and it looked as though this was a decent range to do a Fib study off of. And in this case, because we don't have a retracement, we expect it to go to the higher end of the Fib extensions. And 1.2303 was one of those levels. It was also a level that we had as a reversal pivot and a Fib level, and we thought this was a great level to look at for a reversal. It was also a psychological level. What happened in this case? Let's see. Zoom in a bit. price moved up, and in one candle it went to within about a pip above our price projected area, and tested that area a couple of times before reversing to the downside drastically. Our last example is the yen. On the yen, we again did two price projections, two fib studies. The first fib study was from the most recent swing high that will allow us to see a retracement to the most recent swing low that was before today's price action. We also did a confirming fib study that went from the last major swing high to the last major swing low, which was the day before price action. And when we did those studies, we obtained a target to the downside of 121.51/48. This was a downside target as price was moving down off of news. As we watched, we saw price hit our target, penetrate our target, and begin to congregate within our target. Now, in this case, we had indications that price was going to continue, momentum, speed, continuing down, and trend also pointing to the downside. And as we went forward in time, we saw price break that level, continue on down to the next level, go down to an even further level, reverse back up, and it's been up ever since. So on this day we had five price projections. Three price projections were successful, two price projections were not successful. On the non-successful price projections, the pound came down eventually to that price and has stopped and is currently at that price. The Australian dollar came within 10 pips of it, giving us potential 20 pips worth of profit. On the three price projections that were successful, we had two that hit almost exactly the price area we drew in and reverse. And on the yen, price continued down to our price projection and continued on, allowing for even greater profit if other means besides just price projection were used as an exit, such as a 5A cross. So this is one of the ways that we look at price action and determine what we'd want to do for the day when we're trading at fxbootcamp.com.